So I want to make a quick video showing how to set up a room, a custom room, for this dungeon generator. So it has the correct data for the dungeon generator and works all nicely. So the dungeon generator uses a voxel grid when it's generating the dungeons. And if we just generate this dungeon and we come to these debug options, we can hit a button that says draw all or draw global voxels. And then if we just hide everything, you can see these are the voxels that this dungeon is taking up. And so when it tries to place a new room, like it tries to connect the two doors together and place a room, it checks against this voxel grid to make sure there's no overlaps. So like since there's no voxels right here in the center, that is a valid spawning space. So that means that you could get rooms that like come up and then up through this the center of that area and kind of get really closely intertwined rooms, which I think is really cool. But in order to do that, each room in this dungeon set needs to have data set up for where those voxels are and where the connections between the rooms will be, which are the doorways. And so in order to do that, I wrote this editor tool that makes it pretty easy. And we're just gonna go through and set up a room really fast. But first, if we open up this, we're just gonna make a new dungeon set. And actually, we're not gonna do that. We're gonna just duplicate one of these. And all the rooms that are in the possible rooms lists are the rooms that the dungeon can generate. And it's always going to spawn something from the spawn rooms list first, and it's going to be this big room. But then every time it tries to spawn something, it's just going to spawn this L room, which is this room that we were just looking at. So we have use dead end rooms off, which doesn't matter right now, but so when we spawn this, it's going to spawn the big room, and then it's going to spawn those L rooms off until it meets the target room count. So that's easy, but let's add another custom room to this possible rooms list. So what we're going to do is I like starting from one of these templates, one of these customers I already have. There's a bunch of different ones. But if we go with the dead end room, which is just a small room with one doorway, we're going to just kind of recreate this from scratch, I guess. So we're going to create a new empty, and we're going to call this custom room. On it, it needs a room data script, which is what stores the doors and voxels and stuff the generator needs. We also need a gameplay room, which is going to be like your custom gameplay script that right now I just have it set up to like spawn random props in specific locations and whatever. This is just for the example that comes with it. You can change this to be any kind of script you want if you're not using the example callback script. And then what I like to do is create an empty that we called geometry, where we just put like the actual room meshes and stuff. So to start, we're going to go to voxel mode, and now we have these arrows that if we click, we add another voxel to that side. If we hold shift, we can go back, and if we hold control, we can do it row by row. So it just grabs whatever row you're working on and pulls it up, and we can hold control and shift and delete by rows too. So just for this quick example, we're just going to kind of make a just an interesting shaped room. So maybe it's like kind of like two hallways with two exits, and then we can also like put a upper area over here. Sure, why not? And then let's choose where our doors go. gonna put one right here, and one right here, and one up here on the second floor. And now, when the generator spawns, since these doorways are on different heights, the generator has like a verticality to it, since it's just aligning connecting doors. So the next room is gonna start one level higher, and kind of get this nice height change. And then we're gonna lock this and go to none to get rid of all those arrows, but so we can still kind of see where this room is. And then I have some parts that I like to use when building this. And these are just prefabs with like a floor and a material, or like a doorway. Just super simple stuff. So let's grab a floor, drop it in the geometry, and it's already at the starting spot. We're just going to hit Control D to duplicate it, and then if we hold V and hover over this vertex while still holding V and then clicking and dragging, we can just snap it to that spot. And since this tile of this floor is the same size as the voxel grid, we're going to get everything aligned really nicely. So we're just going to keep doing this. We can select multiple pieces. And there's our floor. We're going to have a second floor up here because we need a floor by the doorway, but we'll throw in some walls now. Usually our floor should be a different color, shouldn't it? Let's grab this blue. Plop in some doorways. We have to make sure that we align like this doorway wall and the floor right to the edge of this voxel. Because if it is sticking out like this or whatever, it's kind of hard to see. See, that white is where the voxel is, and if it's sticking out, then the geometry when the walls or when the rooms connect to each other might start overlapping, get Z fighting. So we just have to make sure that we're aligned to the right spots. We're not clipping outside of this voxel grid. Not gonna actually put walls around this entire room because it takes a little bit of time, but I think the explanation is good enough of good enough example. Then we have a staircase, and we can just plop in here too. Our fancy room. Now, so we will drop it in our rooms folder as a prefab. As we're going to have to make sure some of these objects didn't go in the right spot, so we got to make sure they're in the geometry. Turn this into a prefab now. Now we have our custom room, and we we can stick it on our possible rooms. So now we will only spawn the L rooms and our custom room. So now if we hit play, we have our custom rooms spawning all over the place. And we go explore and find one. Here's our custom room.